Wonderful evening. We're here to celebrate a lot of things. A lot of really good people are here tonight. My name is Don Caller, just to let you know. And first of all, we want to start out by thanking Gina and Troy, Kelsey, Gamery, Troy. Events here, and they're always great hosts, and we just love coming here. The food is excellent, so thank you again for letting us come here. More importantly, what this shows, with so many towns coming, with so many people coming, and I thank you. I see a lot of my friends, my neighbors. I see neighbors and friends from other towns. We're all here to support Chris Coutu for the 19th. And who here does not? Edith has done some good things for our district.
Really?
But, well, okay, I'm trying to be good here. So somebody cut me flat. Yeah? But it has been at least a half a century, and the new blood that Chris Coutu offers us, new blood, new energy, new ideas, and the one thing I will say about Chris, and I'll let him talk for himself, I have seen this man stand by himself in front of the legislature, trying to control spending, control things that are wrong. I've seen him stand alone, and he stands up proudly. He's a man that I support, and he's a man that I hope we all will get behind, work hard, get him into office.
Yeah.
Some other people that are here tonight, John Gilman from Republican State Committee. Because of the redistricting, he will not be part of our state central. No, but John has been very, very faithful in coming to town committee meetings, keeping us posted, giving it his best, and I really applaud Jonathan for his efforts. Thank you, Jonathan. Okay. My friend, and boy, don't we go back, I won't say this for how long, but maybe 15 years, Jeffrey Watt, who is chairman of the Hebron Board of Selectmen. Very, very briefly, and I know Captain only gave me 4 minutes.
Yep.
Okay, but I still got 37 seconds. But Jeff is one of the most dedicated Republicans I think I've ever met. Jeff puts his heart and his soul, and he believes in it. And I know that with people like Jeff, with people like all of you, Chris is going to win.
Yeah.
Kathy Yadinsky. Kathy and I go back about a decade, yeah? Kathy is the first selectman of Marlboro. So, Kathy, welcome tonight. Thank you for being part of this great event. And then finally, and I've got my 2 seconds, because I've been counting, I am so happy to introduce you another Republican from Eastern Connecticut who deserves our support. And this is actually one of those stories of stick to it, I'm going to do it. I give you proudly Representative Tim Atherton.
I just want to touch on that. It's interesting when you close with that. But it was for the same reasons that Chris is in office, that I was looking to get myself in office, not as an attorney, no disrespect to attorneys, but as somebody that was sick and tired of what was taking place. So I interviewed, and I had to say, for 4.5 years to get in the seat that's right in front of Chris's in the House, in the chamber. So Chris, it's been an honor to serve with you. I want you to take a look at this brochure. And it says right at the bottom, fighting for you. And I want to start pre-politician times. And that's when Chris rose his hand and said, I will put myself in harm's way for the values that I believe. And that was in the military. And I thank Chris for that time. But then he did it again in a district that no Republican should have won. He did it in a year that very few Republicans won. And that shows how hard he fought to represent the values of being a Republican, the conservative values, and what he thought Connecticut needed for a direction. So we thank you for that hard effort. in a tough time. We have, and I see it from the inside now. I was never one to say, I'll stand on the side of the street and yell at the building, get me into the building so I can make a change. But when you're outnumbered 99 to 52, it's hard to get enough of them on your side to say, these are wrong policies for the state. Please join us on our side of the aisle to vote down some of this bad legislation. That's why in the Senate we have a chance. In the Senate, it's closer, 22 to 14. They're still outnumbered. But we need you. You all have had a vested interest in this party. We need you to continue to do that. We need to get away from a one-party system for our constituents. If we can't get balance, our constituents' voices are not heard. So when I go and vote for what I believe is the values of my constituents, and I'm outnumbered 99 to 52, those 23,000 people don't have a voice. We need to change that. We need to create a balance. We start in the Senate. We'll follow that up in 2 years in the House. If we can't even get some more this year, we got to work our way up. But I want you to help get a balanced government in Connecticut. And that's why we need to fight harder for this gentleman right here next to me and get him in the House.
Woo-hoo!
And I wish you all the best.